So A is one, so you have the first entries, A is one, and your B is what? Or another possibility is if you allow A to be minus one, what happens again? You put again, you have A is minus one, remember, so C is equal to minus one all over. Minus 1 squared is 1, minus 2 is 1. So in that case, what happens? B has to be 0 again. Then in that case, if B is 0, you have what? Minus 1 over, which is minus 1. It's an integer. So B or A is equal to minus 1, and B is still 0. This one was B.
Yes. Second
possibility is,
yes, suppose we use one for B.
One for E.
Yeah.
If you use one for B, it is already an integer. You're going to be minus 2 times 1. So you have 1 over, okay, let me see. Yes. So it's not an integer, it's 2. B can be 1 actually. Because 1 minus 2 times 1. Is that minimum? Minus 2, which is also 1. So B can be 1. B can be 0 and it can be 1. So B can be 0. B can also be in both cases. In both cases, isn't it? So we have the first one, if you are now writing the entries, where your A is equal to, let's not start from 1. And this will give you B is 0 or U is what?
1.
Is it true? So B can be 0, it can be 1. But it cannot be minus 1. Before it is a minus 1, you will have over 2. Yes. Or A is equal to minus 1. Then B can also be what? 0 or what?
1.
Or is it? It can be minus 1. B can be minus 1 also. I think in both cases it can be 1. Definitely minus 1 will be because minus 1 squared is 1. So this can be 0, 1 or minus 1. 0, 1 or minus 1. So that means A is equal to plus or minus 1. This time we will yield what? B is plus or minus 1. Or even this is one option. The second option, if your A is, is it A equal to? Is it plus or minus 2? A plus or minus 1. Or what's the second option?
Yes.
Plus or minus 2 equal. Plus or minus 3, plus or minus 2. Oh. Yes, equal. So what number A is plus or minus 2? Supposing A is 2, it's plus 2. Supposing A is plus 2, what happened then? Then C is equal to what? You are see becomes 3 all over 9 minus 2 over B squared. This will be an integer only if what? B is what? If B, 9 minus 2 is what? 7. If B is 1, if you have 9 minus 2, which is 3 over 7, which is not an integer. If B is 2,
we have
9 minus 8 is it
3?
So if B can be, so if B is 2, I think you are both here, because this will have 9 minus 2 into 4, which is 9 minus 8, which is 1.
the word.
Civil reviewers. Yes, so B is still, if A is still, one option is that B can be given 1 to 2. But B can also be minus 4. It can also be minus. This is how you get an integer for this. What about if A is minus 10? You have an assist. Is it clear? Yeah, so you keep substituting until you get all of the options. Where are they? These are the options of values which A and B can take so that you then become units. Remember, units mean when you multiply the two, you get one. Yes. So there are all the options that have been given to you. As I said, I'll give you a hint on how to solve this.
Excuse me.
Yeah, okay.
Please, these conditions, are they given?
No, they are not given.
Okay.
They are actually, you imagine them from the definition of units. Remember, actually, the definition of units says, S is a unit. That's the only thing you need to remember. If and only if there exists some y such that x times y will be 1. That's all you need. Isn't it? So we cannot say your A plus B group 2 is a unit. That's what you must do. You start from this definition. If and only if there exists some C plus D 2, such that if you multiply A plus B root 2 times C plus D root 2, you will get 1. And this is what we started with. We now say, what is A plus B root 2? We say that A plus B root 2 is nothing but 1 over
C plus B root 2.
Isn't it? Or if you want to say, okay, what if you are not even looking for A plus B, you are looking for C plus D. Because you know A plus, you are giving A plus B. So what is then, what is C plus D root 2? Then it's going to be
1 over,
1 over A plus B root 2. Okay? And we want to rationalize and say this is times A minus B root 2. A minus B because we did it the other way around. We wanted to get C plus D. What you can also do is you get the same result anyway. What is that if you use, if you now want to look for A plus B root 2, you will do the reverse of this one. Isn't it? This one will now be C plus D. Then you will be looking for values of C and D, not A and B. But it will be the same anyway, because the values of A and B will always depend on the value of C, because they are not allowed to multiply together to give you one. Yes. So that's what we did. We wanted C plus D. That's what we wanted. So that's why we are writing in terms of A plus. Now if you want A plus B root 2, then you write in terms of C plus D root 2. And that's what we did. We say this, then we had A minus B equal. We multiply both sides equal. So we say this is A minus B all over A squared minus
B
squared. We want to say now, we now come and equate C plus D root 2 to this, because they are the same. We say if I want to use the real part, it's equal to the real part of this. The imaginary part is equal to the imaginary.
That's how we want it. I would say, but not as a condition. Why? If one, you want to see to be integer, C can only be integer. C is actually equal to A power over A squared minus 2B squared. But C is an integer. How can it be integer with zero possibilities? We either take A to be 1. Now, if you take A to be 1, what will happen to this? Then you are now contemplating for the values of B. That will make this to stand as an integer. You say B can be 0. But if you put 1 over 1 minus 0, you have 1 over 2.
Sir.
Oh, sorry.
You said we want C to be
an integer.
My question is that can we take negative value to test?
Yeah, it is not allowed to integer. You can check. Integers are almost positive and negative. Just however, we can take A to be plus 1. Why do you think we understand? Because they are only integers. Isn't it? Yes. So, the second thing is here, what if A is minus 1? And it makes sense. So, C can be both positive or negative. Depending, yes. And so on and so forth. You now say only this is one option. What other option do you have? If you let us say A is 2, will this be an integer? Then you have 2, 1 over 2 squared, which is 4, minus 3b squared. Now what about the of B will let this to be an integer?
B will be 1.
Remember, 2 makes it like a square root, maybe challenging. But it may not be an integer. Two squared is four minus 2b squared. And you want to see it to be an integer. Is it possible?
Yes.
How?
By taking b to be equals to 1.
If b is 1, you'll have 2 over. Then this will be 2 power
4
minus
2.
Yeah, it's 2. So you have 2 power
2,
which is 1. I think it's impossible. Yes, I think you can.
When is not.
Yes, so A can be given to 2. And C can remain an integer. But remember, the C and D. They are not supposed to be there. Because not only A that is expressed in terms of A and D. D is also, where is D? D is also expressed in terms of what is D? What was your D?
Minus B.
Your D was, we say it's minus what?
B.
B all over.
A squared minus 2B squared.
So, what happens when, remember we said we are taking A to be 1? We say A is 2. So what happens to this multiplier? And we are taking B to be 1.
Why?
Substitute it here. Do you get an integer? Because B is 1, D is now equal to minus 1. All of our A is 2. 4 minus 2 into 1, that's minus 2 times 1. So this will give you minus 1 all over 4 minus 2. So you give minus 1 all over 2, which is more than 2. Okay, so that means this value is not so. Is that it? So you don't see. What if you take A to be 3? A to be 3 now. So, go back. You are A. Remember, so you are A. You are C now. So A is G. Also, our G square, which is minus 2. And we see that if we allow you to be 1, it's not. But if we allow you to be 2,
with us. So it is allowing me to see the possible when I've seen people taking out of our 9 minus 2 into 4, which is taking out of our 9 minus 8, which is
people going.
Now we go to D.
Okay.
What to D? What are we going to D? Because they both here at C and D. They also have to D. D is minus D. All of our.
The first one is to D.
Remember, your A was taken. Your D was 2. This is going to be minus 2. All of our A squared, which is what? Minus 2 into 4. Did you say B is 2 4? No, this is going to be minus 2 all over.
There is no square there.
Oh, so you're not 9.
That's 9.
This is going to be like that.
That is 9.
So 9 minus 8.
Yes, that is 1.
This is going to be minus
2. It's a non-trivial.
So we are going to go to TD. Likewise for minus 2. But if TD go to 4, if you go to 4, then you want this. As far as our story say, we now the only values are plus or minus 1, plus or minus 3, and you get the corresponding values.
But, excuse me, sir. The moment you test 22 along C and D, and you want them to be
repeated.
Repeated.
That one.
And because
you want to let, remember, all. It defined, the definition is A cross B with D
B to 4, such that both A and B are integers. This one definition. Mm-hmm. And you also say
C cross D, such that both C and D are integers. That is what you want. So it means both A and D belongs to D, must be integers. Otherwise, what will happen if you get a part which is not an issue? They are not units, because they are units in Z. Units A is not unit in R, but unit in Z. Z is now the root of integers. Of course, integers are also ready to be known. Look here. Oh, I don't know this. They are actually ready to be known. You can try one of the advantages, they are abelian group, they are associated, and multiplication in Z is also distributed. So they are actually abelians. Okay, good. I
get you what? Z
of I.
Z of
I.
2 of I. We define it as A plus. I want to see the movement. The zone of just so this one is done. So the second one is Z of I. So to find us A plus I equal to I equals group 2. Where both A and B are in Z. If you want to find me, what you do? You find. You said that in this C plus ID to go such that what? If you multiply to A plus ID into what? C plus ID will get 1. Like okay, this is one point you can only be put. You can only be A plus I B or 2 equal to 1 over C plus N. Just like in this ladder. Good.
Sir,
if you want to express that in terms of C and D, because you always want to see so that this one will not be equal C and D. So then you now use the translation. So you want to continue and say it and only use that C plus I D for 2 is 1 over A plus I. But if I do that,
very easy to be a tough parent, just like it's in our nonsense. Then you rationalize. Isn't it? You rationalize. Again, you say, one equals IG times M times again. So you get what now? A minus ID root 2 on power. This will be on A square 4. Remember the middle term will cancel. So you get what? What's now? What is I times minus I? You cross 1. So this will be plus. So I think the only difference will now be this used to be minus 4. You will now have it as plus. Now what are the values?
Yes, sorry, sir.
Not being a circle of
x squared.
X squared. Oh, not too much. Oh,
sorry,
sorry.
It's 2
plus 2 e squared. Sorry. X squared plus 2 e squared. So you can now start. What happened if I put A equals 1? What will my C be? Because my C is now A over A squared. Just like my B is going to be minus 1. I equal all over 1. Oh, okay, minus. The I will cancel and. Well, as I have cancel out, my C is simply what? Minus 1. B for the root will also cancel. Minus B over what? I think this looks similar to that. What happened? But that is close. If you put A equal to plus, what happens? You get 1 here, this will be 1. Plus what? 2 times 1. You have a problem. If you put A to be 1, let's try. Put A to be. Then you have what? 1 there, then here you have 1 plus 2 b's. This is your C. If I'm doing it what? If I'm doing it b is 0, 0 then. So if I'm doing it b is 0. So b cannot be 1, 1. That's only 2. 1 over minus 1 will not work here. So, now what is your D then? Let's check D. What of D? Whether it was a D. Minus B over.
So B was 0 on the part.
So if B, if A is 1, I have what? B is 0, then I have what? Minus 0
over
1 plus
0.
0, which is minus 0 over 1, which is 0. So that means the first ones are A is 1, B is what?
0.
Only 0. No overlapping. So you now continue again. Try minus 1. Try minus 2. Try. And you do the rest of all. You do it similar, you follow similar to this process. Okay, so see the reality.
Okay,
so put A 0, yeah?
B is 1.
B is.
A is 1.
A is 1. B is 0. Get 1. So this will be 1. This will be 0. So you have 1 in the first bracket. Second bracket. You say what was your answer?
B is 1, B is 0.
B what?
B is 1, B is 0.
You get B equal to 1,
B is 0.
So if you have B is 0,
B is 0.
A is 0. So you put 1, second bracket, 1 in the other one. So what happens when it's 1?
One.
Is it?
Yes.
Present.
No.
No, the question. Yes, of the other is the screen that we are going to and the
other of two
and then
honor of the law. Yes. Or yes, or she. That's a very, we call it mental to the left. We call it a lot of the
yes.
Yes. You can see the same as I am, which is quite simple. Because it will just be the best of this space. Careful as we can stay on it. It will be simple as it is. But that is very difficult to do. But you can walk with all of your tools and all without to do more. You have more exercise.
Okay, now the question. Now, let X be a subset of ring. Let X be a subset. Ring R. Now, the subring generated by the set X is the smallest subring. The subring generated by the subring generated by this set subset X is the smallest. Okay. Subring, okay. Containing S. Subring containing S. Okay. Let us go. Give you some. The smallest ring consists of subring containing S. It consists of finite numbers. It consists of a of finite sums like this. R X or the set of sums I from 1 to N of Ri plus I, where each Ri is an element of the ring such that each Ri belongs to R and each Xi belongs to the subring. In particular, X contains only a solid element A. Then the ideal generated by the element A is Re. Supposing S consists of this orbital solarity.
Sorry?
I want to have a question. Not arranging only of a single element A. Suppose that X contains only a single element of one element and one element set A. Now the ideal. Remember, I do is also a subring. The ideal, then, the ideal generated ring by A is denoted
By the way, it has a simple set of qualities as where arguments. Not always a jail has only, there are only two possibilities for it. It is either 0 or 81. Okay, as we contest only the proper IG score, contest only. The profile and the that's the only profile is there. Yes. We already see that if not us is a unit if and only if R is equal to 1. Okay. If it is to be a unit, it is to be a unit, then it has to contain only profile. That means IE. Normally we note it like this: A is either 0 or A, and the direction by A is what? Is. Well, that is 1, so is equal to 1. Okay? Let's see. This implies that A is either 0 or A is what? 1. That means the ID direction by A is the ID direction by 0. Because the ID direction by A is
1.
When A is equal to 0, what it means is that all the R is available, that your set of all R is R in R becomes what? Set of all what? R 0. Isn't it? R in R. But R 0 are simply what? The 0. Isn't it? Set 0. Or if A is 1, it means what? Set of all R A, R in R becomes what? Set as what? R times 1. Why what? And this will generate a whole array. Yes, so we have other. The ideas are only ones proper ideas. The only one proper ideas. Proper ideas are the 0 and the
1.
The remix. Okay. When R is 0, it generates a 0 ideal. When R is 1, it generates a 1 ideal. The ideal generates. Okay, good. We recall that R is a principal ideal ring, what we call principal ideal domain. For short, if R is an integral domain, and every ideal in R is principal. So, all this is principal ideals. Okay? Now, but R, you can say R is principal ideal domain. Okay? PID. If one, R is an integral domain. That means commutative ring is unit which have no zero here. Two
ever had been. In our is principal. His principal means generates the range itself or his principal is one element generates it. You get just one element. And you are going to generate not the whole ring, but the whole idea. Then you say that idea is. You can remember that the difference between idea, S, and the ring itself. In fact, in any case, S is always a subset of the ring. Isn't it? Of course, it may be the same because you have proper ideas, when you have the same. But generally speaking, S is a subring of. But if in S you pick an element S, in S, and if you now put a generator on S, it's capable of generators of all S, then you say this S is graceful. Indeed. When you pick any element in it, you can generate the rest. Just like this in circular rules, circular rings for them, the integers. If you pick one element and integer, you can generate. Maybe integer number 4. You get integer number 4, maybe you get 5. If you pick one element,
you can generate
the rest of them. You can generate. You can generate. According to your app, according to how to say it, so whether you are X, what is an X? Is your Z file, which is simply 1, 2, 4, and 0. Just pick an element, pick 1 in Z file. Then you can generate maybe using the publisher 4. Yes. So you now say 1. So you say, suppose this is your X now. Say X in Z. Then what is X? Set of format by changing RX4, where R belongs to now. So R in this case, your R is yourself. Then what happens? Then you have what? S is this. And suppose S is 1. So you say this is R. But in this case, the R is multiplied. It's not multiplied. The R is addition 4. So you say R is equal to 1. Suppose you pick the elements of the set R. That is 0. So you have the first one is 0 plus 1.
It's 1.
So you have 0 plus 1, 1 plus 1, 2
plus 1,
plus 1. 3 plus 1,
4 plus 1,
4 plus 1, 5 plus 1, and so on and so forth. See if you can generate this one of you, this one of you, this one of you, this one of you, and 5, you have 5 of the 2. I is 0. This one you want?
6.
6 one. Is a 5
symbol. 1.
I want. So you are going to repeat. You can generate it. From just one element, you can generate it. So that is the list of it. If you establish that this is an idea, then it's principle. But that's the next question. You may ask me, is it an idea? They are asking me to go to the definition of idea and check whether it is an idea. Isn't it? Okay. So, now, remark. If R is an integral domain, then the rings 0 and R are principal. I think we have seen this one, number 2. Any field is a principal identity. Any field. You know the definition of field? Oh, any field by definition, any field, any field is a principal ideal domain. Remember your definition of fields? Is the objective of this unity such that everyone is not a multiplicative numbers? Okay. So it means any x, y you pick in the field help. Or any x you pick in the field that exists y in the field. Such that x times y is one. I think that is the definition of field. This implies what? This implies what? X, Y are units. Are units. Automatically they are units. Okay? And you require what is the ideal domain that you have an ideal. You have an ideal. Any field is a principal ideal. So if you have, suppose now you have suppose X is an ideal. In R, R is, remember R is your field. R is your, or you want me to use F. F is your field. Then what it means is that let xi be an element of x. Then the ideal generated by xi or generated by s is not like this, which is by definition forward Rx such that R belongs to your what? Field. Will this generate your S? Yes. Yes. Will it generate your S? Yes. So, but what you know is that S is a subset of your F. So that means the elements in S are also in that what is presented. So therefore, this implies what? This definition RS, where R you say is in F. Can be, it's nothing but something just like what? Generated will be actually contained in it's actually, of course, it's contained in L itself, but it's also something that restricts, let me say, it's contained in S. In fact, it's equal to S. Okay? Because remember, the S is obtained from X. And notification is defined because it's a field. The L such that S actually more this restricts. R, in this case L, to what? To S. So that means this will actually be the same as this. So every such idea will just generate the other thing. So it's a principle. That means this implies that therefore this end is principle. It's principle. So therefore, and therefore any field, the field itself is actually the limit. Because this is arbitrary technique. If you take y, you will have the same principle. If you. So every idea is going to witness. So the faith is going to witness all ideal. Yes, so this one on the right education now. Euclidean domain. Euclidean domain normally a Euclidean domain. Normally write it for short ED. Okay? For short. Is an integral domain are together with the function. An integral domain are together is a function. Maybe let's call it phi, okay? Such that phi, such that phi maps your ring, similar to zero is your ring minus zero n, and it lands onto z, okay? Or let's say m. And set of numbers. Of course, union zero. It is not dead, it's an especially n, where n is where n is set of natural numbers. So it must be some special z. Of course, it must be for such z. You will see later. To say counter number. So you take element from integral domain, of course minus zero to set of natural numbers plus zero, that means it will be zero, such that these two conditions are such, we call them EB1, the first one. Euclidean domain one, that is the first condition. If whenever A equal to B, if whenever A divides B, of course A, B, that is M. Okay? Then A phi, of course you can have A and B to be in R of the equation domain. Then A phi will be less than that is number one, and number two we call it equilibrium domain two, we call it ED two. For any game in R, the number of integers, A is not zero, such that A is not zero, there exists Q and R. There exists Q and R, such that B is equal to AQ plus R, D is equal to AQ plus R, and R is 0 for 5 of A, R will be less than 5. Okay? These are the two conditions which we require. We call by equilibrium function, then we now call by an equilibrium function on R.
equilibrium and equilibrium. Okay, equilibrium function. Remember your arc is the integral geometry. Okay. Now look at the functions carefully. You have a function, or an equilibrium domain, you have a function from the ring of equilibrium domain that is the integral domain minus zero z such that we are getting two elements here in this ring, A and B. Then you say A by B. K, the function of A will be less than the function. This looks natural from the ring of A by B. Isn't it? So we can really see this from the definition because we know if A by B, this implies B over A is some C, that means B is equal to some A. Now look at this. So you expect if you are now applying phi on B, it's going to be what? Same as phi of A, phi of C. Remember C is not zero. So it means C can be zero anyway because they are all elements of ring. But they are not zero because why? Because it is unit at B minus B. So that means C is not zero. So C is not zero.
So therefore if you are trying to find about D, then it means phi of D is automatically bigger. Is it? It's equal to, but this is equal to, I think you can, this, we can say, this is what is phi of A? This is equal to, so phi of B is simply phi of A times something else. Is it? Some phi of C, of course, which is not zero, times some, maybe some D, where this D is not. So you can see clearly that phi of B is actually bigger than phi of A. Because phi of A times something, maybe multiple so. In fact, if they are an integral domain, then you know, since D is not zero, isn't it? Since D is not equal to zero, then you expect it to be something, an integer. Integer 1 or 2 or 3. So the first one is very clear from this can establish an E P 1. Okay. This will establish the E P 1 as the first condition for equilibrium. The second says take two elements with the same integer. Then you can express this as B can be the expressed as A Q plus R. And so it's also natural because in the two ED two, ED two, what is ED two go? And now if A divides B by definition, then it means B is equal to some AC or some C go. In R, and C is not zero, isn't it? Meaning what? Meaning this implies we can represent B as A Q plus R. Where in that case, what is what? Where what? Where Q is some number, where Q is some number, where Q is such that what? In that case, that means C is what? This is 2 plus something. Plus what? So he expresses as k equal as a r. AQ. Because at 2 points, we say either R is 0 or what? If R is 0, we have no problem, because it means instead of what? B will just be what? AQ plus 0, which is simply AQ. So it's not like AC now. Isn't it? So the first one is something. But if R is not 0, R is not. Remember, the margin is from R minus 0 to N plus 0, so it allows 0 here in the image of the margin. Okay. So R is not 0. And you want to phi of A, phi of R to be less than 5A, so you want to say that R is not 0, but then phi of A is less than phi of A. It means if phi of A is less than, if phi of R is smaller than phi of A, what it means is that this will have a equal value R is smaller than A, isn't it? And it's expected because then, so if R is not 0, then R is from remainder. Okay. After division by Q. Okay. After division by division. Division of what? Of B by 2, isn't it? Yes. So that means therefore it's not an integer. R is not an integer therefore. Because it is an integer, it will be multiples. So you don't need to render that. Isn't it? Mm-hmm. For example, if we say 2 times, supposing A is 2, supposing 2 is 2, A is 3, 3 times 2, plus something. If that something is happening, we just say positive. Isn't it? So that means whatever that is something less than, it's from remember, but it can be an integer anyway. But what it is, you say something less than a, because this is, if you say 2 times a plus 1, that's it. This is 2 times a plus 1. So, supposing, let me use an example. Supposing my B is 7 and my A is 2. What is happening? What is B then? I said 3 times 2, 4 plus 1. In that case, my Q is 3. This is my A. This is my R. Something. They are both integers.
consider for treatment. But we can see that this issue is bigger than that means 5 of 2 is actually bigger than that's what it means. So it means that B by 2 and 9 of 4. Smaller than Q. Okay. Yes. The budget 2 is 1, since 2 is more than 1, the budget 2 is 1, how high is the amount of metal is 0? If that means because if 2 cannot be, if 2 is 1, then I cannot say A, B is equal to A, 2 plus R. I can only say because I can just say B is equal to Q. That is why I don't need that. So I don't need to argue in that case. In that case, my R must be 0. But so when, because B is more than 0, more than 1, that's why it has this number. But R can be 1. So therefore, it means 5 of R is smaller than. In this case, we use 2, actually 8. So that is, you can just, this is the specification for EU. All this is the specification for the second condition. Then, example. We'll give you an example now. That's the motivation. Define a function phi. Define a function phi on what? Okay. On z. Okay. Like this. Phi will take z to, of course, to n union 0 divided by phi of n. Phi takes n to the master bar. That's the master bar. So pi will take an element from z and it assigns to its actual value. Remember, n has no zero. So that's why you need to say it was zero. But when you compile it together, it didn't say z was zero. So that's why you need to say it was zero. Is this an equation for you? That's position by phi is an Euclidean. The main function. But the fact that it's the Euclidean domain function, that it defines if it satisfies ED1. You want it to do it. The problem is not to say it can be really by 5. That we can easily write. But I can give you this. The first one says, well, if you want to say so, if A divides B, take two elements maybe. You like to give you some things. Consider M and M elements of Z. Take two of them. Such that what? Such that M divides, and what does that mean? This will imply what? M is equal to C of M. For some what? For some C in what? In M. not zero amount. But I'm still saying, because N has no zero in E. So that was a need to say it's one. Now what is phi of N? Now what is N? What is phi of N? Is phi of what? C no, which is actually phi of C.
Dot.
Phi of
M.
Okay. Then what happens? Is smaller than what?
Phi of N.
This is the scale. Then you can try it. Or if you want to see it clearly, I can represent it as by absolute value then. But what is phi of M? By absolute value, simply M of absolute value. So because already we do this for this like user recognition form. Then yes. So this I can write as absolute value of C, which I can write as by definition is absolute value of C, absolute value of C not equals zero, of course. C not, you know. But C and M are also are all in the natural numbers. So clearly phi of N plus, so that means what? So N is simply by definition equal to C times what? M. So it means that what is M? So that means this clearly tells you what that is. And absolute value is something bigger than that. Yeah. Or the other way around, you want. Or M, absolute value is smaller than that. And that means phi of M is smaller than phi. Clear. What is the time? I have taken 2 hours.
Oh, it's almost
1 hour.
No, after
1 hour. So we have to be there.
By pi of
take capital is your polynomial is indeterminate. Who is the degree of then by five, that five is satisfies E1 and E what's the two conditions? I can also give you hint that is just not in some here in the notes. Field of integers as is indeterminate. You consider a field, then the polynomial ring L of X, where X are indeterminate over L, F has its colors now. See, F, so you have F1, F of X1, F of X2, F of X3, F of X3. They are all the two. They are going to generate the polynomials now. And what is that? If you are going to have an integral domain, it's going to be a ring. Polynomial ring is a ring because it satisfies all the definitions of ring. It is associative, possessive multiplication. Polynomials are associative, isn't it? They are available roots, isn't it? If you add the elements of F of X1 plus F of X2 is going to be the same as F of X2 plus F of X2. They have more commutative rings, and they have units because they have zero polynomial, isn't it? Yes. So you have an integral domain. Now, if I can write F of X, this is a set of all polynomials to n by F of X to the degree of X. So in finite F of X, for example, you can say F of X1 is simply X1 squared is equal to X1 plus T. F of X2, maybe X2, 2X2 cubed plus 3X2 plus X. F of X3 is something. Maybe three x 0. Just one 3x and 3x plus 2. F of X4 maybe S to the power 3 x squared. These are polynomials. As long as you can generate as many as possible. But you now associate a polynomial to its degree. Degree is the highest one. So this is why it's from degree 2. It's from degree 3.
What?
It's from degree 1. So F of the polynomial, F of X1, F of this one. That's what this one is doing. Okay, associate a polynomial to its
degree.
That's it. You can easily verify that it is an equilibrium domain. And then also. So let me stop here. This one will be you. This one will be you. This one is 5. Then it's expensive. Because that's the next question you may ask me. Is it an idea?
They were asking me to go to the Ministry of Identity and check whether I have this number. Isn't it? Okay. So, now, remark. If I am the integral domain, then the range 0 and R are principal. I assume we have seen this one, number 2. Any field is a principal ideal domain. Any field. You know the principal field, oh? Any field by definition. Any field. Any field is a principal ideal domain. Remember your definition of fields? This is the objective of this unit, such that everyone has zero element has been multiplicated numbers. Okay. So it means any x, y, the peak in the field have, or any x peak in the field that exists y in the field. So such x times y is one more. I think that is the definition of field. This implies what? This implies that x, y are units. Are units. Automatically they are units. Okay? And you require for the rest of the ideal domain that you have an ideal. You have an ideal. Any field is a principal ideal. So if you have, suppose X is an ideal in R. R is, remember, R is your field. R is your, or you want me to use F. F is your field. Then what it means is that let xi be an element of x. Then the ideal generated by xi or generated by s is denoted like this, which is by definition forward R x such that R belongs to your what? Field. Will this generate your S? That's yes. Will it generate your S? Yes. So, but what you know is that S is a subset of your F. So that means the elements in X are also in that particular. So therefore, this implies what? This definition of X, where R you say is in F. Can be, it's nothing but something inside what? Isn't it? Will be actually contained in, it's actually, of course, it's contained in L itself. But it's also something that restricts, let me say, it's contained in S. In fact, it's equal to S. Okay? Because remember, the S is obtained from S. And multiplication is defined because F is a field. Okay. So, L such that S actually will this restrict, which is this restricts R
in this case L, to what?
To S.
But that's an adhesive actually sentence. It's a similar sentence. So every such idea will just generate your thing. So it's a principle. That adhesive implies that therefore this end is principle. It's principle. So therefore and therefore any fields, the field itself is a limit. Because S is arbitrary detector. If you take Y, you will have the same principle. If you so every ideal is going to be principle. So the field is going to be principle ideal. Yes, so this one and the rapid definition now. Euclidean domain normally a Euclidean domain. Normally we write it for short ED. Okay? For short. It's an integral domain are together with the function. An integral domain R together is a function. Maybe let's call it phi, okay? Such that phi maps your ring similar to 0 is your ring minus 0 n and it lances onto z, okay, or let me say m and z of numbers. Of course you know 0, it is not dead, it's an especially n, where n is where n is set of natural numbers. So it maps into some special z. Of course, it can map into such z. You will see later. To say we count the numbers. So you take element from integral domain, of course, minus 0 to set of natural numbers plus 0. That means it will be 0 such that these two conditions are. As we call them ED1, the first one. Euclidean domain 1, but in the first condition, it will be 1. If whenever A invites B, if whenever A invites B, of course A, B, that is L. Okay? Then A phi, of course you require both A and B to be in R of the Euclidean domain. Then A phi will be less than that is number one. And number two, we call it Euclidean domain 2. We call it ED2. For any AB elements in R, number of integers, A is not 0, as that A is not 0. There exist Q and R. There exist Q and R, such that B is equal to A Q plus R. B is equal to A Q plus R. And
R is 0 or 5 of A R will be less than 5. Okay. These are the two conditions which we require. We qualify equilibrium functions. Then we now qualify
an equilibrium function. Equilibrium function. Remember your arc is the integral domain. Okay. Now look at the functions carefully. You have a function of an equilibrium domain, you have a function from the ring of equilibrium domain that says the integral domain minus 0 c such that whenever you take two elements here in this ring, A and then B, then you say A by B. K the function of A will be less than the function. This looks natural. From the limit of A by B. So we can easily see this from the definition of B. Because we know that A by B, this implies B over A is some C. That means B is equal to some A. Now how much means? So you expect if you are now applying phi on B, it's going to be what? M and phi of A, phi of C. Where C is not zero. So it means C can be zero anyway because there are all elements of ring. But they are not zero because why? Because you expect R to be minus C. So that means C is not zero. So C is not zero. So therefore, if you are trying to follow D, then it means phi of D is automatically bigger. It's equal to, but this is equal to, I think you can, this, you can say, this is, what is phi of A? This is equal to, so phi of B is simply phi of A times something else. Isn't it? Some phi of C, of course, which is not zero, times some, maybe some D, where this D is not. So you can see clearly that phi of B is actually bigger than phi of A. Because phi of A times something, then you want to do so. In fact, if there are an integral domain, then you know, since D is not zero, isn't it? Since D is not equal to zero, then you expect it to be something, an integer. Integer 1 or 2 or 3. So the first one is very clear from this can establish an E P 1. Okay. This will establish the E P 1 as the first condition for equilibrium. The second says take two elements with the same integer. Then you can express this as B can be the expressed as A two cross R. I think it's also natural because in the two ED two, what is ED two go? Now if A divides B by definition, then it means B is equal to some A C or some C go. In R, and C is not zero, isn't it? Meaning what?
will this employment represent be as a Q plus R? Where in that case, what is what? Where what? Where Q is some number, where Q is some number, where Q is such that what? In that case, that we see is what? It is Q plus something. Plus what? So he expresses this as KQ plus ARQ. AQ. Seems not like that. I think that so they're not the same. They're not exactly the same because they don't have a KQ plus ARQ. And AR is R and AR is equal to R. Okay? That's what you meant. Isn't it? So in that case you have two options. Now if R is zero, you go for it. Because there are two conditions. You say either R is zero or what? If R is zero, you have no problem because it means instead of what? B will just be what? AQ plus 0, which is simply AQ. So it's not like AC now. Isn't it? So the first one is something. But if R is not 0, then Q. Okay? Yes. Because if Q is 1, since Q is not a number, but if Q is 1, our R is as much as vector is 0. If that means because if Q cannot be, Q is 1, then I cannot say AB is equal to AQ plus R. I can only say because I can just say B is equal to Q. Yes, I don't need that. So I don't need to argue in that case. In that case, my R must be 0. But so when, because B is more than 0, more than one, that's why it has this number. But R can be one. So therefore, it means pi of R is smaller than pi of A. In this case, we use two. It's actually A. So that is, you can just, this is the explanation for EDQ. What is this? Yes, the explanation for the second condition. Then, example. We'll give you an example now. That's the motivation. Define a function pi. Define a function pi on what? Okay, on Z, okay, like this, pi will take Z to, of course, N union 0, divided by phi of N. Pi takes n to the master of one. That's the master of one. So pi will take an element from Z and it assigns to its actual value. Remember, n has no zero.
The last time I need to say it was it, but we try to find it here. This is the same as it was it, no? So, that's why we need to say it as it. Is this an equation for you? Yes. Is this by price? Pi is an equilibrium. With a main approach. But the fact that it's the equilibrium domain, so that it defines if it satisfies ED1. You want it to do this. Your brother is not to say it can be easily by 5 minutes. That way, you can easily by 5 minutes. But I can give you this. The first one says, well, the easy one says, if any by before, multiple elements may be let go. I'll give you some hints. Consider M and M elements of the spectrum of the such that what? Such that M divides, and what does that mean? This will imply what M is equal to C of M. For some what? For some C in what again? Not view models. For some C and M, because M has no zero F in E. So you don't have to say, you need to say it's positive. Now what is phi of N? Now what is N? What is phi of N? Is phi of what? C no, which is actually phi of C. Phi of M. Okay? Then what happens?
Phi of M is
smaller than what?
Phi of N.
This is still this scale. Then you can try this. Or if you want to see it clearly, I can represent it as a bi-absolute problem. But what is phi of M? Bi-absolute problem. Simply M absolute problem. So because already we can do this for you, like instead of using the definition form. Okay? Yes. So this I can write as absolute value of C, which I can write as, by definition, is absolute value of C, absolute value of C. C not equal to 0, of course. C not, you know, because C and M are also in the natural numbers. So if you layer the phi of M, layer, so that means what? So N is simply by definition equal to C times what? M. So it means that what is M? So that means this clearly tells you what is that. N absolute value is something bigger. Then what? Yeah. Or the other way around, you want. Or M absolute value is smaller than M. And that means phi of M is smaller than phi. You can use the position as the clear. What is the time? I have taken 2 hours.
Oh, almost
1 hour.
No, after 1 hour.
So we have to leave after
to give it to Dr. Poo. Then I will do the same way. I will give it to the next, just like it. That's my mind, number two. Let that be it. Let that be it. Then, the polynomial ring. The polynomial ring for the one.
Yes.
It's an integral. It's an integral. Define a matrix. Define from this polynomial distance to n natural numbers in n0 by pi of will take capital as your polynomial is indeterminate, okay? Who is the degree of then by five, that five is satisfies E1 and E2. What's the two conditions? So if you hint, that is it has not been solved yet in your notes. Field of integers, as is indeterminate. You consider a field. Then the polynomial ring L of X, where X are indeterminate over L, F has its colors now. You see, F, so you have F1, F of X1, F of X2, F of X3, F of X3. They are all they are going to generate the polynomials now, depending on what their degrees are. If you are going to have an integral ring, it's going to be a ring. Polynomial ring is a ring because it satisfies all the definitions of ring. It is associative, well, that's the multiplication. Polynomials are associative, isn't it? They are available roots, isn't it? If you add the elements of f of x1 plus f of x2, it's going to be the same as f of x2. Plus F of X, they don't commutative rings, and they have units because they have zero polynomial, isn't it? Yes. So I have an integral ring. Now if I divide F from F X, this is a set of all polynomials to N by F of X to the degree of X. So in finite F of, for example, you can say F of X1 is simply X1 squared. X1 plus D. F of X2, I mean X2, 2X2 cubed plus 3X2 plus X2. F of X3, something. I mean 3X0, just not 3X, I mean 3X plus 2. F of x4, s to the power t, x squared,
These are some nominees. As long as we can generate as many as possible. But you now associate a colonial to his degree. Degree is the highest one. So this is why it's from degree 2. It's from degree 3.
What?
It's from degree 1.
3.
It's from degree 3. So therefore, the polynomial type of S1 therefore is what? 2. That verse is what you see. Okay, associate a polynomial to its
degree.
That's it. You can easily verify that it is an equilibrium relation. Then to answer. So let me stop here.